They were the perfect TV family, and the Waltons were so aligned with good old-fashioned values that US President George H.W. Bush referred to them while campaigning for re-election in 1992.
We are going to keep on trying to strengthen the American family, to make American families a lot more like the Waltons and a lot less like the Simpsons.
They really were the ideal American family. Judy Norton played the eldest daughter on the series, Mary Ellen Walton. She joins us now from Hollywood. Welcome to Studio 10, Judy.
Good morning. Thank you.
Now, the Waltons had such a special place in the hearts of so many people. Did you have any idea it would become such an iconic part of pop culture?
When we started, we had no idea that it would have the enduring effect on culture that it has, and we're all so proud and privileged to have been a part of it.
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful moment in time. Now, Judy, Mary Ellen was a really strong-minded young woman. Were there many similarities between yourself and the character you played?
Absolutely. I was a tomboy growing up, involved in a lot of sports. I did play baseball. I wish I'd been as rebellious in real life sometimes and as she was, but it was great to vicariously get to portray all that. It got it out of my system.
Was it a happy set? Because one of your castmates, Eric Scott, now he played Ben Walton, he said last year there was enormous pressure from the studio bosses, but he never actually felt appreciated by them. Did you feel like that too?
There was a certain amount of that. It was a period in time where children in television were not particularly the focus of shows, so the focus was much more on the adults, and we were a bit more peripheral, so we felt that behind the scenes as well.
Wow, so even the Waltons wasn't actually like the Waltons. Was there much pressure on you? I mean, we saw the comments from George H.W. Bush before saying that you guys were the perfect American family, even though you were made up. Did you feel pressure to actually be like that, that you were America's golden children?
I felt personally a responsibility to try to be a good role model because of what the show represented, and I think that the cast still were very protective of the image of the show and wanting to not really do anything to destroy that sense of what the show created, because it was very real, and what you saw, the love between us, was very real.
So no drink or drug scandals, because it would have been too damaging to the fabric of the nation.
No, I mean, and there really wasn't anything. We were kind of boring in that sense.
Well, your new movie is very different. It's called Inclusion Criteria. You've written it, you've produced it, you star in it. It's a psychological thriller. Was it a labor of love for you?
It was. It came from a kernel of an idea that I had of something that I had read, a story I'd come across, and that was very disturbing to me. And it just kind of percolated for me, and I felt that I wanted to find a way to bring that subject to life. And it's a woman. I play a woman who really isn't sure if she's being stalked or if she's just going crazy, if she's losing her sanity, and she's very concerned for her own mental well-being. And so it was great to dive in there and explore that, both as a writer and then as an actor to play that.
It's because the movie does look at that, you know, at victims of mental illness, and you talk about diving into that role. How heavily did you have to get into researching when you were writing the script and playing the part?
Well, I can't tell you too much because it'll give away things in the story. But I mean, it was definitely an emotionally challenging role to play. So there was a lot of research and depth that I had to be willing to dive into to play the role. So every day on set, it was an emotional roller coaster. So
wow.
I just had to gear up and be ready for whatever scene we were going into that day. It was always good to end the day and just put it away.
I was going to say, speaking of emotional roller coasters, Ruth, there's, you know, the cliche of the curse of the child star is still very much alive and well. How hard is it for someone who's been so defined by a role they've done as a child to actually continue to work as an adult actor and make it?
There's definitely a lot of challenges. It closes some doors and it opens others. And I think after an initial adjustment period when the show ended, where I went and went back to theater, my theater roots, and started doing theater, musical theater, then I started exploring how I could expand my tool set so that I could find those doors that I could open rather than the ones that were shut. And so that's when I started getting involved in writing and directing and a little bit of producing and singing.
So you sort of have to start over in a way.
Yeah, but I think that's life. I think we're always, no matter what business we're in, we have to stay relevant, keep working to reinvent ourselves to stay current.
Mm. Well said. Well, inclusion criteria will be in cinemas very shortly. You can head to judynorton.com for all the details. Judy, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you very much for having me.